All right, my friends, Ancestral Mathematics. In order to be born, you needed 2 parents, 4 grandparents, 8 great-grandparents, 16 second-great-grandparents, 32 third-great-grandparents, 64 fourth-great-grandparents, 128 fifth-great-grandparents, 256 sixth-great-grandparents, 512 seventh-great-grandparents, 1,024 eighth-great-grandparents, and 2,048 ninth-great-grandparents. For you to be born today from 12 previous generations, you needed a total of 4,094 ancestors over the last 400 years. Think for a moment. How many struggles, how many battles, how many difficulties, how many sadness, how much happiness, how many love stories, how many expressions of hope for the future did your ancestors have to undergo for you to exist in this present moment? And you have the audacity not to go for it? You have the gall and the gumption not to take a leap of faith? All those 4,400 and whatever ancestors that have bled, sweat, cried, toiled, struggled, been down the valley of the shadow of death, and you keep choosing rainbows, puppy dogs, and unicorns? Who are you? We live in the most blessed time ever. We have more access to information, more knowledge, more resources than ever before. And you're going to sit around crying and whining how you can't find your way in life. You can't find your purpose. What do you think? What do you think for your ninth great grandparents when they were going across the open range, battling coyotes and badgers and the Apache Indians? They said, oh no, we're done. We're just going to go back home. We don't want to get scalped no more. They had to worry about being scalped. You've never had to worry about anybody Indian ripping your fucking head off of your body. You don't even have to worry about anybody killing you on a daily basis. You don't ever have to go to war. You don't ever have to take bullets. You don't ever have to take arrows. They're all fictional. And you're sitting in your room, in your thoughts, worried, wringing your hands until the water falls out. Oh my gosh. Don't do it for what the fuck? Do it for all those ancestors. Do it for you and your ancestors in your name, the 4,094 that made sure you got a chance to be here today.
Bro, that's the most powerful thing ever. I've never seen that, but I never. So some people go, I got a small family. The hell you do, just because you don't know them. Man, 4,000 people, so I could be here on this show with you. I better bring all the energy. That's all I got to say about that. You talked about it too. I said the other day, there's no struggle anymore. Hey, I used to have to go out as an ancestor and go get some food. And I was looking for maybe a deer. Oh, shit, there's a bear. Huh. All of a sudden, I'm looking like I got to do something, right? Hey, I've had to deal with struggles before in my life. That stuff right there is real. You never know what you've had to overcome just to become part of this. Not only that, you were the Michael Phelps of swimmers in order to get here. That's another one. You won that lottery too. So not only did you have all those people, you won the Michael Phelps lottery too to end up. I just look at this way. You have to do something with your life. This is not by accident. You don't just exist just so that you can, I don't know, scroll TikTok all day long. I don't know, so that you can get likes or something. That's not what you exist for. You exist to go outside and make something amazing out of your life. You exist to go outside and be a good example to people. You exist so that you can go out and make your kids better, your wife better, your husband better, your cohorts better, your employees better. You exist so you can make the person on the other side of that counter better. That's what it's about. People get up every single day and don't realize how much struggle it took for them to live this amazing life that they have right now. I heard this the other day, and it just goes to show, because so many people have so much potential, have so much they can do. But there was this thing I heard the other day. The human brain is the single most technologically advanced computer used in the most mass quantity by the highly unskilled labor. So think about that for a second. You have all the tools at your entire disposal ready for you, and you don't use it to create good things. You don't make a good algorithm. You have the best computer known to man at your disposal, and unskilled labor is being used on that every single day. Just imagine if you got a little good at fixing that algorithm we just talked about a little while ago.
Take my headphones, shake my brain out of my ear real quick. Bro, you just blew my brain to pieces with that one.